Welcome back, everybody. Many of you have heard about Connecticut's campaign for public financing of campaigns, and it has certainly raised, has come to be quite an issue here in the state. This upcoming year, 2010, will be the first time that it applied to statewide candidates, and that's why it's so important. And we want to talk about that over the next several minutes with Heath Folley. He is the policy director for the Yankee Institute for Public Policy. Heath, thank you so much for coming in and being with us on our program.
Well, good morning, Tom. Thanks
nice to have you here. Our pleasure. You know, this is going in, and first of all, explain for us what we're talking about when we talk about the campaign of financing the new way for 2010. In essence, what would it do?
Sure. Well, what the public financing of campaign system called the Citizens Election Program, what it does is it offers candidates the opportunity to raise small dollar contributions between $5 and $100 as the maximum, and if they raise the appropriate number of contributions,
$250,000,
then they qualify for a public grant from the state to finance the entirety of their campaign. It adds up to $3.25 million for governor candidates, and then $750,000 for candidates for constitutional offices statewide.
Attorney General, Secretary of the State, Treasurer, that kind of thing. But now it was ruled unconstitutional, right?
That's right. The Connecticut District Court ruled that the Citizens Election Program was unconstitutional because it unfairly treats minor party and petitioning candidates. It's very difficult for minor party and petitioning candidates to get access to the public funds because they're required to meet additional thresholds that the major party candidates, Republicans and Democrats, aren't required to face. So it makes it much more difficult for an independent candidate to get access to the public funds and be competitive. So the courts ruled that unconstitutional.
Now the proponents, those people who are very much in favor of this, know something has to be done. So the legislature has to make it constitutional in order for this to come into effect and play a role in 2010. I'm just wondering,
right,
you know, how much of a job is that going to be for,
right,
the legislature to do that?
Well, there's a number of different proposals out there. At this point, I think that the most sensible thing to do is simply to require all candidates to meet the same goals, the same thresholds that the minor and petitioning party candidates meet, which is that in addition to raising the small dollar contributions, you also have to solicit petitions. It is a higher threshold. It would be much more difficult, but it would serve to get the candidates out into the members of the public and talking about their candidacies, collecting those petitions, so that people would have would clearly have the endorsement of the people in order to qualify for public financing.
So it would not be just if somebody has millions and millions of dollars, they would still have to go out and get the signatures.
That's correct. That's correct. But at this point, the legislature has to take some form of action in order to make that happen. The federal district court is going to hear the case in January, but until that point, the candidates running for governor now, for example, are really in legal limbo because they are raising funds as though the program was going to be there in many cases, but it may well not be there. If it continues to be unconstitutional, then either the legislature has to take remedial action or the program will be invalidated.
Well, how much money are we talking about that would come out of the state, public money, total, do you think, in 2010?
Sure. Well, the account in 2010, the Citizens Election Fund, the program, or the fund that finances the program, will have approximately $71 million in it for the 2010 campaigns. It cost about $17 million to run the legislative candidate races in 2008. So with the addition of all of the statewide candidates, the expense will be much higher. I suspect that it will be in the neighborhood of $50 to $55 million for that program. And given the state's budget deficit concerns, I think that mixed with the flaws that the program have, it makes good sense to temporarily suspend the Citizens Election Program so that we can fix the problems that exist in the Citizens Election Program and at the same time mitigate the budget deficit that we currently face.
Yeah, that's a lot of money, $71 million.
Absolutely.
And of course, do you like Do you like the current plan? There are some people who say that the plan put forth really wasn't a good plan because people with a lot of money could basically tap dance around it, would not be affected by it. Do you think it's a good plan?
Well, there are problems with the publicly funded system as it stands. The proponents of the law promoted the system because they felt that it would level the playing field. But in my analysis of state senate races, there was no change in the number of incumbents that were reelected. That was basically the same as 2006 and 2004. The number of competitive races was exactly the same, and there was no discernible difference in terms of benefiting anyone other than incumbents and the major party candidates. Independent candidates were locked out completely. So I think that there are real structural problems with the citizens election program, and I think that it would be well worth the legislature's time to go carefully, thoroughly review the program soup to nuts, and then fix the program or get rid of it altogether.
Final point, Heath, how quickly does the legislature have to act?
There's a deadline built into the law. They wrote it understanding that there was a good chance that the law would be invalidated by the courts, and so April 1st is the deadline. If the legislature doesn't take action by then the program will be out for the 2010 elections completely, and all candidates will be back to the old system.
And might even be before that, because the courts want to have some time to take a look at it before it makes a ruling. So
sure, absolutely.
It could probably be the middle of March or something.
Right.
In any event, Heath, thanks so much for coming in and being with us on our program. We'll be following this very closely.
Very good.
Thanks so much.
Tom.
Appreciate your time.
It.